teenage girl in a big city, and I'm not here alone. Who are you?
What's up, guys? My name is Paul Vodin.
And what do you do?
I make filmmaking, photo tutorials, tips, gear, stuff on YouTube.
So basically, we met today in Toronto to do some street photography style, and to be very honest, this is my first live face-to-face collab, so let's just do it together.
Awesome. Let's go!
All about battle of two different brands, two different cameras, and I have Canon EOS M50 and Paul has Sony. The reason why I chose this little camera is because, hey, that's the only camera I really use for vlogging, and second, I just need something very light and very small and compact. I'm using a kit lens 15 to 45 millimeters, and if you want to check out Paul's gear, I highly suggest checking out his channel where he will be posting his version of his video. And the location I'm is in downtown Toronto, and it's Yonge and Dundas intersection. It's a very popular tourist area. And here comes my fear of shooting in a big city. I always have that little anxiety to go to a big city because a lot of people, a lot of unknown, but because I'm shooting with Paul today, I feel like I'm getting that support from him, which is really, really helpful. So hopefully next time I can do it on my own. And you know, a lot of people which are just starting to film themselves, they are vlogging, they probably have to deal with the same thing. So having someone along always boosts you, always helps. Not in a big city too often, so whatever I see, I just want to photograph pretty much. Whatever it is, from meaning photographing people, photographing buildings. I like to capture emotions, and I think sometimes I'm just too fixated on primarily older people because they show the life and what they went through. So the way I am looking for a subject is I'm just walking by. I see a sitting person or walking person, and I see just very interesting building. I frame it and then I just kind of wait for something to happen. I like to find reflections, and usually in the windows, in the mirrors, and just different angles.
He said, hey, has she stopped me just a second? Just a second away from all the pain. You told me if I leave.
For me, the biggest challenge has always been the lens. I'm so used to shooting with telephoto at the weddings, and in telephoto I mean 70 to 200 millimeters, because I love candid photos, and I wish I could take more candid photos on the street, but with this lens, 15 to 45 millimeters, I would have to sprint, so I would have to run to get there fast, and I can't. It's kind of blocking me. So when I'm standing on the street, I see maybe someone very cool on a bicycle, or I see very cool somebody crossing the street, but they are too far away from me and I can't get there. So that's a challenge sometimes you have to deal with when you have a short lens. Some other photographers, they actually prefer the short lens because they can get very close to the subjects and they feel like they are part of the scene. For me, I rather stay unnoticed and grab that candid moment as it happens.
You have a heart, and then you said, hey, we can build it all up again.
I literally finally had a chance to see some reflection in a window where there was this woman sipping a cup of the coffee, probably looking at the cute jewelry, and hopefully she was picking something good. So one of these shots which I actually liked today. It's a little bit under pressure because when you see something great, everything is moving so fast in a big city that before you actually get that shot, or you get there, it's already gone. You have to react very quickly.
Get back home again.
No, I think I'm obsessed with this photo. Like, when I have it in my mind, I feel like I need to make it work. I have to get it until it's right.
Such as opposite of mine. If it doesn't work, I just give up and I move on.
You're the missing piece of puzzle. in my heart, hey.
We had a conversation with Paul, and I just actually found out that his career was not always in photography and video. So, Paul, why do you do what do you do now?
So, a lot of people don't know, I used to be a physiotherapist. I went to school for a lot of years, I think 7 years total. And I liked it, I loved the career, I loved what that job was, but I really didn't like the lack of flexibility. So I had no flexibility in terms of family once we had our first child. And I was always doing this on the side, and it became a point where if I put more energy into this work, this business, I could actually build it up to the same as my other career. So I did that, I worked really hard, and then 2 years ago I completely switched careers, and now this is the only thing I do. And
how scary was it?
Yeah, doing that initially was really scary. I'm just lucky that I have a supportive family and a supportive wife who believes in what I do, and if you put in enough work and do it the right way, like I didn't just start doing this and then leave it right away, I made sure I built it up on the side, putting in hours late at night along with when I was working full time. So when I was ready to switch, it wasn't like a complete shock. It was sort of a smooth transition, more or less.
We can build it all up again. We can dance in the summer rain. I know we can fight it and keep it. We'll get back home again. Oh, I'm feeling.
One thing I totally noticed about people in big city like Toronto, that they are always surrounded by a lot of tourists. And because I also look like a tourist today, I really don't care how I look because I just want to feel comfortable for photography. They don't mind I am around with the camera, and some of them, they know I'm taking photos of them and they really don't mind. They are used to it because, like I said, many tourists are always around snapping photos. So in a big city, it's a little bit more easier to take street photography photos. If I am in a small town like Oshawa and I'm taking photos, usually people stare at me because there are not too many bloggers, there are not too many people with cameras, there are not too many tourists. I would like to invite you to see Paul's channel. The link is here, also in the video description below. He's talking about techniques he's using as he's doing street style photography, and you can actually check out his photo from the Sony camera. He will tell you a little bit more of this about his gear. It was a little bit overwhelming to shoot here, but I'm glad I did and I'm glad I came. I know I will be back in Toronto again to shoot some more. Right now, all I can say, if you liked today's video, give it a thumbs up, subscribe to all future videos. If you have any questions, comments, simply want to say hello, you can do so in the comment section below. And I'll see you in the next one. Ciao. Ahoy.